Hallelujah, hallelujah. What another beautiful and awesome day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day to always get into thanks right now. Another day to always get into praise right now. Another day to always get into glory right now. Another day to always magnify and shout out his holy name right now, because God is good all the time and all the time. God is good, and he is so worthy, hallelujah, he is so worthy to be praised. And if you know that God is good all the time, and all the time God is good, give him some praise right now in the house. Give God some glory right now in the house. Magnify and shout out his holy name right now in the house. Say, Jesus, you are my healer. Jesus, you are my provider. Jesus, you are my rock. Jesus, you are my salvation. Jesus, you are my everything. Jesus, you are the one that I trust. Jesus, you are the one who's going to deliver me. Jesus, you are the one who's going to help me. Jesus, you are the one who's going to heal me. Jesus, you are the one who's going to make everything possible for me, Jesus, because I believe in you. I trust in you, God. And I'm going to continue to walk with you, Jesus, in the darkness of the valley, God. I'm going to continue to praise you in the darkness of the valley, God. I'm going to continue to glorify you, God, in the darkness of the valley. I'm going to continue to worship you in the darkness of the valley, God. I'm going to continue to do what you have called and chosen and considered me to do, despite what I don't see, despite what I don't know. I trust you, Jesus. But Father God, just help us right now, God. I say, Father God, help my sisters right now. I say, God, help my brothers right now. I say, God, help myself right now to help us to understand your timing, God. Because God, the flesh is getting weakened right now, God. But God, we got to trust you, God. Even though the flesh is telling us to give up. Even though the flesh is telling us to throw in the towel. But God, we know that you oversees the whole picture. So God, you help your sons right now. God, you help your daughters right now. God, even help me through this battle that we are going through. Help me with this battle that we are facing right now today, Jesus. Because we can't do it alone. Glory to God, we can't do it alone. So God, we're calling out your name right now in the mighty name of Jesus to help us in the way, God, that we know that you can do it, God. Because we know it's not too hard for you. Thank you, Jesus. We know that it's not too difficult for you, Jesus. We know it's not too hard for you, God, because God, you created this whole thing. God, you can do this whole show by yourself. You don't need your son's help. No, you don't. You don't need your daughter's help. No, you don't. And you don't even need my help, God. So God, we are calling out your name today. Hallelujah. To help us through this battle. Because God, one thing we know for sure, one thing we know because according to the word, you had never lost a battle whatsoever. Victory does not come easy. Victory does not come easy. So God, we're going to continue to press in even though the situation is hard. We're going to continue to follow you even though it's hard. We still picking up our cross and follow you even though we know it's hard, God. But God, but you got to help us. And we know that you will. God, we know that you're going to come through in a mighty and major way, God. God, we know that you're going to show up. We know that you're going to show out. So God, you help us right now. We praying for strength right now today, Jesus, to help us get through this situation, God. Because God, you know exactly what we are going through. Yes, you do. God, you know exactly what we are facing right now, God. And God, we need you in a mighty, mighty major way today. Amen. Amen. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And I'm here right now, then, on behalf of myself, all my sisters, all my brothers right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm here right now today to repent of our sins. Because, yes, we dropped the ball today. Yes, we even made some mistakes today. Yes, we even fell short of his glory and his grace today. Every last one of us did that. There's not one of us on this planet called Earth that said that we are perfect, because we're not. Because we make mistakes all the time. There's no need of trying to hide it. There's no need of trying to sugarcoat it. God already know what you done before you did it. He was aware of the problem. He was already aware of the situation, my brothers, my sisters. It is our job to keep it real and be honest and say, God, we messed up. This is what we did. So I need my keep it real brothers and sisters right now today and to join with me in repentance. Can you please join with me right now? Heavenly Father God, let's come before you right now today in the mighty name of Jesus. Please forgive me, my sisters, and my brothers for anything, Jesus, that we've done wrong in the sight of your eyes. Father God, please forgive me, my sisters, and my brothers for anything, Jesus, that we had in our heart that was not part of you. Father God, please forgive me, my sisters, and my brothers for anything, Jesus, that we had in our mind that was not part of your Father's will. Please forgive us. Wash us clean right now. Purify us through your blood right now. Clean us up as white as snow right now. Oh, Father God, I want to say thank you right now today for forgiving us for our sin. Thank you, Father God, for not remembering our sins anymore. Thank you, Father God, for the clean new slate. Thank you, Father God, for the new chance. Thank you, Father God, for the new opportunity. God, you didn't have to do it for us, God, but you did anyway. So, God, we want to give you the thanks and praise and glory for it in your holy, precious, mighty name. Amen and amen. And before I get started, I always like to take the time out to give our Heavenly Father God all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory. Oh, Heavenly Father God, I just can't thank you, Father God, for this awesome and beautiful blessed day today. I just can't thank you, Father God, for who you are, what you have done, what you're about to do. I just can't thank you, Father God, for your grace and your mercy. I can't thank you, Father God, for our health and our strength. I can't thank you, Father God, for the food that you have blessed and prepared and put on that table, the clothing shoes that you have put on that back. I just can't thank you, Father God, for your words and your promises. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you are a man that you should not lie, that you stand on your words, that you stand on your promises each and every day in the mighty name of Jesus. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you are a healer, you're a provider. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you are on-time God. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you are a faithful God, a loving God, a kind God, an unjust God. I just can't thank you, Father God, that we can always depend on you, rely on you each and every day in the mighty name of Jesus. I just can't thank you, Father God, how you're moving mountains right now on our behalf, and we don't even see it or realize it right now. I just can't thank you, Father God, for our blessing right now. I can't thank you, Father God, for our breakthrough right now. I can't thank you, Father God, for our anointing right now. I can't thank you, Father God, for our deliverance right now. I can't thank you, Father God, for our double portion right now. I can't thank you, Father God, for our more than enough right now. I can't thank you, Father God, for the connection right now, the resources right now, the help right now, the rain right now, the abundance right now, the overflow right now. I just can't thank you, Father God, because we know that you have our back right now. We know, I just can't thank you, Father God, because you never leave us or forsake us, that you never break our heart. I just can't thank you, Father God, what you're about to do in our life. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you're about to do a new thing in your sons and your daughter's life. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you will show up and show out in our life. I just can't thank you, Father God, how things are about to start lining up in our life, how things are about to start manifesting and taking place in our life. I just can't thank you, Father God, for what you're about to do. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you're about to put us at the right place at the right time. I just can't thank you, Father God, because we're about to meet our Boaz. I just can't thank you, Father God, for the connection. I just can't thank you, Father God, because you're about to open up the floodgates of heaven and that you're about to pour a blessing on your sons, a blessing on your daughters, a blessing on me, Jesus, then I can be able to receive it all. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. 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 I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I worship you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I glorify you. That's why I magnify you. That's why I shout out your holy name the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I put my heart out to you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I brag. That's why I boast about you all day long, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just 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 can't thank you enough. Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. And if you're ready for God's word, let the church say amen. But let Jesus know right now, that you can't thank him, that you can't thank him enough. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And he is so worthy to be praised. Amen. Amen. I want to talk to my sisters and my brothers today to let you know that trouble does not last always. Trouble has a time when it starts, and trouble always has a time when it's going to end. But in your troubles right now, in your difficulties right now, in your hardships right now, even in your trials and your tribulations right now, my brothers and my sisters, there are hidden treasures and blessings that's in it. That's why you are in the trial that you are in right now. That's why you're in the hardship that you're in right now. God want to know, can you handle the hidden treasure? He want to know, can you actually handle the blessing? Because there's a blessing that's in that trouble. There is a blessing that's in that hardship. Oh, help me, Jesus. There is a blessing that's in that dark situation. There are hidden treasures that is in there. Our job is to keep the faith. Now, I know it's hard for us right now. I know it's difficult right now because we still in the human body. We still respond to flesh because our body is still attached to the flesh, even though that we're still hanging on to the spirit, but we still are in a fleshly body. So, yes, it will come a time, I mean, Jesus, that the flesh will come to a part in our life. They might want to start taking over. And the reason why the flesh want to take over, because the flesh don't want you to receive the hidden blessing, the hidden treasure that you are going through in your difficult time. Is that making sense to somebody right now? Is God talking to somebody right now? Because I know he is. Trouble does not last long. God will never allow you, my brothers and sisters, to go through this difficult trial alone. That's the first thing. God will never allow you to go through this difficult trial if there's not hidden treasures or blessing in it. That's the second thing. God will never allow you to go through these difficult trials if there was no purpose or plan behind it. He just won't do it. He loves you too much, my sisters. He love you too much, my brothers. He love you too much, serving LT, for you to go through what you're going through if there's not any hidden treasures behind your trial. So these trials that we're going through, these trials that we're facing, these tribulations that we're going through, these hard times, these difficulties, the word of God says we should be happy because we are going through it. And I know some days and sometimes we are happy. But it comes sometimes when we don't see things happening on the physical because we can't see with the physical eyes. So yes, that's when the flesh begins to take over our situation. And right now the flesh is at a point right now it is vulnerable in our life because the flesh is telling us to give up. The flesh is telling us to walk out on God. The flesh is telling us it's never going to happen. It's never going to work. Look how long you've been waiting. Ain't that happening yet? The situation is still the same. The circumstance is still the same. Your problem is still the same. I thought you serve a big God. I thought you serve a mighty God. I thought that you said you can call on God's name and he will be there right there for you. Has he came yet? And we might not say, no, he ain't came yet. But in the spirit, it's already done. But the flesh is telling us you might well give up on God because God has given up on you. God has never given up on you, my sisters, my brothers. I'm going to tell you that one thing, because the enemy will always try to deceive you. He will never tell you the truth that God has already worked it out for us. It's already fixed. It's already solved. Even though we don't see it right now, even though we might not be aware of it right now, but it's already done. And I know it's hard right now. I know it's difficult right now. I'm not going to be the one to tell you that it's not, because it is, because I'm still facing it. I still wrestle with it. I still struggle with it. So that's why I'm here to preach this word, not only to you, my sister, my brother, but I'm preaching the word of God to myself. And God said, LT, you just hold on just a little bit more longer. It is hidden treasures in your trouble. God never allowed pains without a purpose or a plan of victory behind it. He never allowed it. He allowed it because he already know what's up. He allowed it because he already know how he's going to take place. He allowed it because he know how he's going to show up and tell the enemy, didn't I tell you one time I spanked you before, so I got to spank you again? Trouble does not last always. And I believe that this trouble that we are going through, that we are facing, this trial, these tribulations, these hardships, these difficulties, is coming down to an end. And the reason why I know it's coming down to an end, because the enemy himself has a weak spot. And their weakness is when we praise, it's weighing them down. That light that we have, is that light that we have inside of us, it is wearing down the darkness by the second, by the minute, and by the day. Eventually, that light is going to overtake, oh, help me, Jesus, that light is going to overtake it, the darkness that we don't see, my brothers, my sisters. Get ready. Trouble does not last always. And we're going to read for two Bible verses today. The first one we're going to read from James 1, verses 2 and 3. And we're going to finish off at Job 42, verse 10. The first one is James chapter 1. And we're going to read verses 2 and 3. And we're going to finish off at Job 42, verse 10. And if you have your Bibles open, let the church say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whatever you face. Not your company, not your friends, not your family members, not your in-laws, not your co-workers, not the people that you go to church and fellowship with. He said, but you, my sisters, but you, my brothers, when you face trials of many kinds. He said, because. He said, look at the because. Because is a cause in that. Because the cause is, it's a blessing that's in it. It's hidden treasures in it. And it's more than enough that's in it. Because you know that the testing right now, this trouble that you are going through, this hardship that you are going through, this difficulty that you are going through, it is a test of what your faith, hallelujah, develops. Perseverance. Perseverance must finish its works, that you may be what? Mature and complete, not lacking anything. So the blessing in the hidden treasure that's in your trouble, can you handle it right now? If God was to give it to you right now, can you handle it? And the reason why he has not showed it to you, the reason why he's not giving it to you yet, because you can't handle it yet. It's more than what you can think. It's more than what you can bear right now. God knows your strength, my sisters. God knows your strength, my brothers. He knows your ability. He knows things that you don't know about yourself. So that's what the word of God tells us in 1 Corinthians, that he won't put more on us than what we can handle. God knows that you can handle this type of trouble. He knows that you can handle this type of pain. He knows that you can handle this type of backlashes, these hardships, these difficulties. He knows what you can handle, and God's going to see you do it every step of the way. And I know right now it's hard for you to say it. It's hard for you to concept about it. But God said, I see the big picture. I see the other side, where you're going to be at. I see the victory where you're going to be at. I see the more than enough that has your name on it. I see the open doors, oh help me Jesus, that have your name on it. I see the hidden treasures that have your name on it. I see the breakthrough that have your name on it. I see the miracles, glory to God, that has your name on it. Trouble does not last always, but you had to get through this last stretch of trouble, because that's all what it is. It's a last stretch right now. And we're going to get through it. You already been through the worst part of it. So you can't go no worse than when it already was when you first got into the trouble. Now, you better come out of it. And the only way that you're going to come out of it is because God is going to help me, Jesus. He's going to deliver you out of it. So that's why we got to continue to trust God's timing. And we got to ask God, God, help us to understand your timing. Because God, the flesh is beating us down. The flesh is kicking us. The flesh is smacking us. The flesh is body slamming us. The flesh is telling us to give up. The flesh is telling us to walk away. The flesh is telling us, God, that it's over with, that you ain't going to come through for us. That's what the flesh is telling us right now. The flesh trying to make us feel guilty about the situation, my God. Don't you see what your sons and your daughters, even myself, don't you see what we are going through, God? But you say, I would never put you in that predicament if I didn't think that you can handle it. I know the areas that you are strong in, that you only know that you're strong in, my son and my daughters, even you too, LT. I know what you are capable of, my son and my daughters, even you, LT, even though that you don't know that you are capable of doing it. I put that trouble there for a reason. Because I know what I'm about to do for you. What I'm about to catapult you, you had to go through this first. Because this is going to be the first stage of the trouble. Because it's going to be many more stages of trouble. But I had to put you through this trouble first. Because when the second trouble comes, you're going to be like a mini vacation to it. Because you're going to say, okay, I've been through the first one. So the second one is going to be a mini vacation. I'm going to sit back and I'm going to relax. Because I know my God put me through the first one and he helped me get through it. He's going to help me through the second one, the third, the fourth, the fifth, and so many of them. Glory to God. Right now, even in your troubles time, he said, consider it pure joy. He said, you need to be praising about it. You need to be worshiping about it. You need to be glorifying his holy name. Say, thank you for the trouble that came in my finances. Thank you for the trouble that came in my marriage. Thank you for the trouble that came in my health. Thank you for the trouble that came in my house. Thank you for the trouble that entered my children's life. Thank you for the trouble that came in my ministry. Thank you for the trouble that came in my business deal, because there's hidden treasures in that trouble. It is blessings that's in that trouble. Are you following me what I'm saying? Consider it pure joy. Give God some praise because you're going through it. Everybody not going through trouble like you're going through. Everybody ain't facing a storm like you are facing, my brothers and my sisters. God chose you for a reason. I don't know why he chose you. But he chose and handpicked you for a reason. He knew that this time and this day was going to come. It might have been a surprise to you, but it was no surprise to our Heavenly Father God whatsoever. He already knew it. He knew it before you was born. He knew when it was going to take place, the right time, the right second. So that's why we got to continue to ask God for help. God, help us to understand your timing, because there's no way that you allow us to continue to go through this. If you didn't have no perfect timing, how you was going to get us out of it? Are you following me what I'm saying? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's go to Job 42. And we're going to read verse 10. Job went through the same type of trouble that a lot of us was going through. Job 1, God spoke to the devil himself and asked him, what are you doing? And the enemy said, go back and forth on earth to see who I can mess with. See, the enemy cannot touch you in your finances. The enemy cannot touch you in your marriage or your health or your dreams or your business or your ministry unless he get permission from God first. He can't do nothing because he holds no power. He has no right and he has no authority over you, my brothers, my sisters. He had to go to the master, our king, our healer, our deliverer, our provider first. And God said, have you considered my son? Have you considered my daughter? Have you considered serving LT? There's nobody on earth like them. They are blameless. And God said, go ahead and add it. So the enemy got bold. He said, you take their heads away from me. I promise you, God, they'll curse you out. I promise you, God, they'll turn away from me. So God said, I'm going to give you a best shot. Let me remove the head from my son. Let me remove the head from my daughters. Let me remove the head from serving LT. And I promise you, they won't bag me out. I promise you, they won't cuss me out. I promise you, they won't turn their back against me. And that's what God did. Job went through the same thing. Job had everything a man should want, a man should have. So God had to take it just to prove a point. And Job told his wife, he said, why we should accept the good and not the trouble? So Job already knew that trouble don't last always. Job already knew the same God who made a way the first time, glory to God, going to be the same God who's going to make a way a second time. And my brothers, my sisters, the point I'm making to you right now today, this is your first rodeo when you've been in trouble before. Think about using trouble one time before. You didn't know how you was going to get out of that trouble. Then God come through. You didn't know how and when he's going to come through, but he did it, right? So you think about that. The same way he came through for you the first time in trouble, it's going to be the same way, the same time, how he's going to come through on this time while you're in trouble. And there's hidden treasures and blessings in that treasure, in that trouble. How I know? Job 42, verse 10. If you haven't, let the church say amen. Amen. After Job had prayed for his friends, the Lord made him prosperous again and gave him twice as much as he had before. And all his brothers and sisters and everyone who had known him before came and ate with him in his house. Do you see it was hidden blessings and treasure in Job's trouble? See, the trouble that you're going through, the trouble that you are facing, these difficulties, these hardships, they are hidden blessing and treasure. So every trouble is not actually a trouble. It is a hidden treasure that is inside of that trouble, that hardship, that difficulties, and whatever it is that you're going through. Do you see there was hidden treasure in Job's life? Job didn't see that God was going to bless him with twice as much. Job went through the same thing we were going through. He called out God's name so many times, and he said, God, are you here? He looked for God from the north, the east, west, and south, and all the time God was silent. How many times we have called out God's name, my brothers and my sisters, and the only thing we hear is, and the reason why we hear, because God is letting us know that he is still with us. He has not left his side. He's going to get us through this. He is telling us we got to continue to go on and through these dark valleys, these dark situations, because they are hidden treasures and blessings in your trouble. The point I'm making to my brothers right now, the point I'm making to my sisters right now, and the point I'm making to myself, trouble does not last always, and there are hidden treasures in your trouble. And I believe and I declare right now today in the mighty name of Jesus that you, my sisters, you, my brothers, that you will receive twice as much because the pain and the suffering that you went through. The word of God said God will pay you back double for the pain. He will pay you back double for the trouble. He paid back double for the hardship, for the difficulties, because you went through it. Not only that you went through it, but you trust him and you never turned your back on God. Get ready to receive your double. Get ready to receive your more than enough. Get ready to receive your prosperous life and abundance of overflow this year in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know who I'm talking to right now today. I don't know who I'm preaching to right now today, but I claim it and I receive receive my double portion right now in the mighty name of Jesus. So my sisters right now, my brothers right now, if you know that God is talking to you right now, open up your mouth and give God some thanks in the house. Open your mouth and give God some glory right now in the house and say, thank you, Jesus. I will receive my inheritance. I will receive my double portion. I will receive my more than enough. I will receive my blessing and my breakthrough, because there are hidden treasures in the trouble. And trouble does not last always. Amen? Amen. And if you know that this word is for you and God was talking to you, give him thanks and praise and glory right now today. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life, to guide us, direct us, use us. And I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, by us praying a simple little prayer, that God is already working everything out in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me or leave me a comment, my YouTube channel is withers.alt. Always put Jesus first place. Always seek him. Always honor him. Always praise him. Always put him first place in your life. Always continue to pick up your cross and follow him. Always put your faith and your trust and hope in Jesus. Always continue to pick up your cross and follow Jesus, no matter where. Always continue to pray for your fellow brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if you know them. It doesn't matter if you ever seen their face. Prayer helps and prayer changes things. I'm always going to continue to keep y'all in prayer, my sisters and brothers. The only thing I ask y'all guys to do for me, continue to keep me in prayer and keep me lifted up too. This is Servant Minister LT. I love y'all in Jesus' holy mighty name. God bless you. Amen.